most first-class spaces should be accessible at the moment, but I may be able to venture down to third class for a spell through Scotland Road on E-Deck. I believe I'm boarding before anyone else. Robin, right now you're the most handsome man on the Titanic.
Well, hello there, everyone. Welcome to the Titanic Honor and Glory demo. This is part two. This is just a very quick introduction. I won't be speaking over the whole video, just this little introduction to let you all know that this is part two of the demo. We will be exploring first class, parts of third class, and a little bit of the boiler room. That's right. Now, some good news is that in a couple of days, I will be releasing a full video of the fourth demo of Titanic Honor and Glory, where we will have access to first, second, third class, the deck space, the stern of the ship, more of the boiler rooms, and the bridge. And my personal favourite, the wireless room. So look forward to that, guys. Thank you very much for watching and enjoy the video.
I especially commend them for modifying the bulkhead. I never cared much for what was on the Olympic. The lifts are out of order. That's fine. Real men don't take lifts. Lifts are for women, Claire says. Robin, take the long way up. Cabins upon cabins. love the wood detailing here. It's absolutely perplexing. Now that's a craft I can really respect. Lovely wood. I've always been fond of wood. When younger, I used to cut wood for the poor folks two streets over. My neighbors started calling me Robin Wood. They always laughed, but I don't know why. I wore that title proudly. Does remind you of Paris, though excepting the smell of overflown sewage. Wonderful memories are coming back to me of that city. That this room would have its tables already set. Mr. Gotti hasn't even boarded yet. Oh well, top marks for presentation. Thank you. I see Tommy Andrews is already on board. Why does this surprise me? His drawings are scattered about like toys in a nursery. Well, I shouldn't intrude here any longer. I suppose this won't be open any time soon. A shame. I would enjoy nothing more than a cup of tea and to sit with a book in the lounge and, well, lounge. A nice Arabian motif with cooling colors as passengers relax after their time in the baths. But what a poor state these workers left it in. Who on earth is that lucky dog testing out the electric bath? And I believe I see a sliver of the plunge bath as well. This is glorious. You can near well see half the length of the ship in this corridor. A stark contrast from the first-class accommodations, I should say, but still a major improvement from the other liners I've inspected. In all honesty, I envy these people in the lower class. The world is open to them. They move to America and build their future how they choose. They could be loggers, for example. But Father wanted me to be a surveyor like he and his father. No logging for you, Robin. Now wash your ears. Oh dear, the door is open. Perhaps I'm not supposed to look in here, but I can't pass up this opportunity for a little adventure. Oh, if Claire were here now to see me being so daring. How by Edward did I get myself here? Climbing too high, I think. No, Robin, it's not your time to get your angel wings just yet. No, not just yet. Quite hot here. Where are the workers, though? Well, I suppose they're likely firing up the other boiler rooms. These machines are massive. 29 on board, propelling the ship through the water like an untamed beast. I anxiously await their performance during the sea trial shortly. Finally free and not held back from anything. No Mr. Tundry in sight. Just freedom. This open space looks like a fine spot for gathering and mingling between all parts of Europe as they make their journey across the pond to the New World. Perhaps a place on the West Coast, like Seattle.